Let us start an important concept in surface tension, that is capillary action. We can write about capillary that a tube of a very narrow bore is called capillary. And about capillary action, when we study, we'll see when a capillary is dipped, normally in a liquid, it is found that inside capillary, liquid level either ascend or descend relative to surrounding level of liquid. This phenomena is called capillary action or capillarity. This phenomena is called capillary action or capillarity. Now, to understand this phenomena, why the level rises, actually this normal dipping is not necessary. This we have just written in definition, but even if you dip a capillary in an inclined manner, then also the liquid level will ascend or descend due to capillary action or capillarity. To understand this, let's discuss a physical situation. Here you can see we are given with a container in which water is filled, and say a glass capillary is placed right above the water level. Now you can see, if we dip the capillary into the water level, see what will happen. As the capillary is dipped, here you can see, due to the contact of liquid at the surface of this capillary, a meniscus is formed. And as a meniscus is formed, you can see, automatically a curvature is developed, as the capillary we have considered to be a very narrow tube. Then on the two surface, the curvatures are joined and a common curvature is developed. See, in this situation, we consider a point A above and B below this curvature. So these are the two points A and B. Then here we can see pressure at point A, we know it is P atmospheric because point A is in contact with the normal atmosphere, and point B is right below the curvature, and it is on concave side towards the atmospheric pressure. So here we can say at point B, the pressure will be less than the atmospheric pressure by a value 2T by R. If R is the radius of curvature for this section, so we can write pressure at point P will be P atmospheric minus 2T by R. If R is the radius of curvature of this section, or the meniscus which is formed due to the contact of liquid with the capillary walls. And if we talk about a point C, which is just in the level of point B, but it is in the surrounding liquid layer, then we can say pressure at point C will be certainly, it is P atmospheric, as the layer of liquid is flat. So it must be equal to the pressure just outside the liquid layer. Now, in this situation, in the liquid at a horizontal level, pressure must remain constant. And at P, at point B, if pressure is low and at point C it is high, then this liquid will be pushed into the capillary from the surrounding directions. And due to this push of liquid, the liquid level will start rising in upward direction. Here you can see how the liquid level will rise here. Here we can see that liquid will be raised up to a level, say it is raised up to a height h. Then we can say, Now the pressure at the level of C will be written as this was the point B and this was the point A. So in this situation we can say pressure at point C now can be written as pressure at point B plus H rho G, and the two must be equal. And at point C we have already seen that pressure is equals to P atmospheric, and at point B it is P atmospheric minus 2T by R plus H rho G. If it is equals to P atmospheric, here we can see that the height up to which the liquid level is raised up can be directly written as 2T by R rho G, where R is the radius of curvature. In this situation, if we just talk about the spherical section of which this meniscus is a part, and say if this is the radius of curvature of the section R, and if a small r is the radius of this capillary tube, and as we know well that theta is the angle of contact made by the tangent to the meniscus and the wall of capillary. So in this situation here we can see in this right angle triangle this angle will also be theta, and the radius of capillary is r. Then the radius of curvature can be written as r by cos theta. If we substitute here, here we'll get the height to which the liquid level will rise. This is 2t cos theta by small r rho g. This height we call capillary height or capillary action height to which the liquid level will be raised in the capillary due to the pressure difference which is created because of the contact of liquid with capillary walls, and it is mainly because of the curvature developed which created a pressure difference, and due to low pressure area developed the liquid in the surrounding will push it and the level will rise up till at the surrounding layer level inside the capillary pressure will be equal. This is the way how we find out this capillary action height and the phenomena why in capillary the liquid gets raised up. The phenomena we call as capillarity or capillary action. As we have just now discussed the capillary action, similarly we can discuss similarly one a liquid having theta more than 90 degree for contact with a given solid surface. Then we'll see the liquid level in capillary tube will fall below the surrounding layer level. Here we can see in this situation, if we are given with a container with a liquid, and you can see the contact edges are having convex shape because the angle of contact is more than 90 degree. And say we dip the capillary tube. Now you can see as the capillary tube is dipped, a meniscus is formed in convex surface upward. And if we take up two points A and B just above and below the meniscus, here you can see pressure at point A can be written as P atmospheric because it is in contact with the atmospheric air. At point B, as it is on the concave side of meniscus, here pressure will be more than that at A with the excess pressure 2T by R. So pressure at point B can be written as P atmospheric plus 2T by R. And if at the level of B, if we take another point C in the surrounding liquid, pressure at point C, we can directly state it will be P atmospheric because the layer of liquid here is flat. And at point B, pressure is more than that at C. So we can say the liquid will start coming out from the capillary because here pressure is more. Due to which we can say the level of a liquid in the capillary will start falling. Here you can see. So here you can see the liquid level within the capillary tube will fall by a distance H, in such a way that pressure at point B now be equal to the pressure in the surrounding level at another point D, which is at a depth H below the normal layer of liquid in the surrounding. So here we can simply calculate pressure at point D is P atmospheric plus H rho G, and the same must be the pressure at point B, which is P atmospheric plus 2T by R. So in this situation, we can write that capillary height H is equals to 2T by R rho G. And we know that the radius of curvature of a meniscus can be given as R by cos theta, where small r is the radius of capillary tube. So this can be given as 2T cos theta by R rho G. This is the same expression which we have obtained in the previous slide for when capillary height was positive, as the liquid was going up and the meniscus was having a concave shape. So, as here angle of contact is obtuse, this cos theta will be negative and the capillary height itself will be having a negative sign in its expression due to cosine of the obtuse angle taken. So, we can simply write the liquid level will instead fall compared to the case when angle of contact was acute, where the liquid level was rising in the capillary tube. There is also an important application of surface tension, the capillary action or capillarity, you just keep in mind for both kind of liquids.